Hello guys! Welcome to our channel! I am Mark Yulo. Today we have another topic for our Tech Talk. But before that, I would like to encourage you to subscribe to our channel and hit the all button of the notification bell to keep updated on all our upcoming videos. And to those viewers who have questions regarding the topic we discussed today, kindly comment down below. Now, let's watch this video. So, pag-usapan natin ngayon ang mga recommended tools for measurements on sound technology. Okay? So, siyempre, bilang isang sound operator or sound technician, isang sound technology practitioner, kailangan may mga tools tayong ginagamit. Okay? And, you know, just to let you know, pag sinabing tools, it is the possible gadget or equipment that we use for measuring and to identify our audio transmission, including our audio receive, okay, yung mga nare-receive nating audio signals. And this is very important na meron tayong mga tinatawag na reference at mga tools, okay? And in our daily sound or audio operations, importante na meron tayong mga investment on this, okay? Hindi po pwedeng dinadaan lang sa pakiramdam dahil hindi ito pag-ibig. Okay, ganun ba yun? Sabi nila yung sound daw dapat malagabog. Ano malagabog? Ano yun? Kaba ng dibdib mo tuwing nakikita mo siya? Okay? Okay. So, kaba ng dibdib mo kapag nakikita mo na yung mga minamahal mo, mga minamahal, marami yun ah. Okay? So, number one, recommended tools for measurements on sound technology is a multimeter. Okay, so what is a multimeter? A multimeter is a measuring instrument that can measure multiple electrical properties. It is a typical multimeter can measure voltage, being voltaje, okay, resistance and current. So it's a voltage, which is the yung B, okay, resistance means to say nakikita mo yung ohms, di ba? May ohms na symbol, okay, and the current. In which case, it is also known as volt-ohm milliammeter or BOM. Hindi DOM, ha? BOM. Again, it is volt-ohm milliammeter. Analog multimeters use a micrometer with a moving pointer. Mayroong moving pointer. Di ba nakakita na kayo doon, guys? Analog meter yon. Okay. To display readings, digital multimeters or DMM or DBOM have numeric display. So, ito kailangan sa lahat ng mga sound tech, lahat ng mga electricians, lahat ng anyone involved in electronics should have a personal multimeter. Now, I did remember when I'm still doing installation, no? I need to also to test the voltage in the AC outlet. Lalo na sa mga probinsya, minsan taas-baba, spaghetti, pababa ng pababa, no? Pataas ng pataas. Pataas-pababa, inconsistent yung voltahe ng kuryente sa ating wall outlet. Kaya minsan nasisira yung ating equipment. And one of the things that we need also to have in our equipment, in our audio-video equipment, should have an ABR, an automatic voltage regulator. Okay? So it is very important meron tayong ABR. Now, we need to measure plus, okay? Minsan nangyayari, nagkakaroon ng tinatawag na static. So, we need to know how to measure. It's because sometimes, yung ating mga equipment minsan, yung ating mga unit, audio equipment unit, ay mayroong tinatawag na static. So, try natin i-test using the multi-tester. Baka may tumawid na kuryente o mayroong tinatawag na issues with the grounding. Something like that. So, this is one of the things that we should have, a multimeter. Next is, on sound technology, we should have a sound level meter or SLM or a decibel sound pressure level meter. So, a decibel sound pressure level meter measures, okay, or we call this sempre sound pressure level meter, is used to measure the acoustic energy produced by your speaker system. Take note, produced by your speaker system, not to measure the audio signal in your mixing console? No, but these sound level meters will be able to measure the output loudness, which is the acoustic energy coming from your any source, whether it is an acoustic drum or acoustic instrument or yung tinatawag nating backline or instrument amplifier located in our stage or inside our studio. And we use this, okay, to identify, not using by only by our ears. Kapag gumagamit tayo ng ear, hindi rin tinatawag na accurate yung ears natin in terms of numbering. Although we could train, but wala naman talagang tinatawag na digital ear. Meron ba digital ear na golden ear? Oy, I can hear 85.97. Wow, ang galing nga. 85.97 dBSPL. I don't think so. So, kailangan may reference. At ang ating speakers were measured in the laboratory in the anechoic chamber, okay? Using test tools. Mamaya pag-usapan natin yung mga iba pang tools na yon. Not just only sa pakiramdam, dahil hindi yan pag-ibig yan. Okay? Kailangan malagabog, ma-base, hindi po eh. But there should be a reference, okay? A reference measured sound level coming from your sound source or coming from your speaker system. Something like that. Okay? So it is very, very important na meron tayong reference point. Kung wala tayong reference point, pwede masabihin na, oh, I can hear 90 decibels. Remember, there should be a stated distance. I can hear 90 dB at a distance of 3 meters away from the speaker system. It should be the correct statement. Kailangan tama po yung pagkakapaliwanag natin doon. Kasi anyone could tell that they could hear 90 decibels, but it depends on the distance from the source. Again, it depends on the distance from the source. Okay? So there is also tinatawag na common handheld instrument with a microphone. And when you are going to do sound measurement, you should be able to use condenser microphones. I did remember there's a sound engineer. I'm not going to mention the name. Use a dynamic SM58 microphone to test the loudness of the speakers inside the studio. Now, the best recommended is a condenser microphone that is designed for so-called acoustic measurement. Okay? Acoustic measurement. So again, a sound technician or a sound engineer or an audio engineer should have at least maybe 2-3 or different types of SPL meter. And there are also it should be calibrated. Kailangan calibrated, naka-tuned well. Hindi po lahat ng SPL meter ay naka-calibrate, kailangan po nakatono ng tama. And pangalawa, yung built-in microphone ng ating cellphone used for our sound level meter, it should be also calibrated. At kailangan huwag at maaari type 2, hindi type 3. Kasi pag type 3, hindi po yan ganun ka-accurate. Okay, so our mobile phone, the microphone of the built-in sa ating mobile phone is not 100% accurate. And don't measure like this, no? So dapat naiikot at dapat ganyan, no? Although it is omnidirectional, though technically dalawa talaga microphone yung mga bagong mobile phone, pero mas maganda talaga yung meron kayong dedicated microphone. And also, the handheld SPL meter, again, should be able to measure different weighing scales. Weighing, no? May flat, may A, may C, may A, may C. Okay, but we're going to talk about that during our masterclass. Next measuring device that we can use on sound technology is a distance meter. Okay? Ang distansya nasusukat din. Parang kayo pag naglayo kayo sa isa't isa.
You see.
Okay, ganun ba yun? Okay, so a distance meter is used to accurately determine the distance of an object without contact by the way of laser. Ma, pwede pala yun. Nang walang contact, masusukat pala ang pagmamahal nyo sa isa't isa kahit malayo kayo. Okay? Pwede ba yun? Sana all may nakakapag nasusukat din yung pagmamahal nyo sa isa't isa. Okay? Okay? So, pwede ba yun? Sana, no, mayroon nagagawang ganun, nasusukat yung pagmamahal. Okay? So, this is a digital distance meter, or you could also use a typical medida metric, no? Yung metro, okay? Pero medyo alang-anin, mahirap naman kung nakasabit na yung speaker mo tapos gagamit ka ng ano, ng metro, medyo mahirap. So I suggest you can buy a distance meter. May ginagamit ako distance meter saka yung tinatawag na yung para sa golf. Okay, laser din yun eh. Medyo mahal nga lang ng konti. Okay, again, this is also recommended. Why? It's because you should know what is the distance of that listener to your speakers and your speakers to another speakers, etc., etc. You need to have a distance meter. Next, BU meter. Okay, dito kayo tumitingin, ha? Diba, pag sa mga analog mixers, a BU meter or standard volume indicator, or we call this SBI. SBI means to say standard volume indicator, is a device displaying a representation of the signal level in audio equipment. Again, this should be monitored regularly during the performance of the band or during the use of the audio system. Hindi na talaga kayo dapat lalagpas talaga sa 0 dB on the analog. Okay? Kaya nakikita ninyo, pagdating po ng lagpas ng 1, di ba pula na? Red means to say, alarming na yon. Okay? Not recommended. Kung nakakita ba kayo ng kulay pula na pinto, papasok pa ba kayo? Di ba hindi na? Okay, so I suggest you should not go above 0 dB U. Okay? Now, there is also another thing here that we need to check, your LED meter that can be found in audio equipment, okay? Especially if you are using an analog, we call that DBU meter, decibel unload meter, and you should, as I mentioned to you a while ago, that you should not go above 0 decibels, okay? And for you to know what is the headroom of your mixing console, you just have to check the maximum clipping point, which is at 12 dB here. It's not suggested. Kaya mas mahal yung ibang mixing console eh. Yung ibang mixing console, mapapamahal ka talaga sa kanya dahil maganda ang kanyang specifications. Okay? Napamahal ka ba sa kanya dahil kailangan mo siya o dahil kailangan mo siya dahil mahal mo siya? Ganun ba yun? Okay? So, hanggang 24, may nakikita nga ako, hanggang 32 eh. Hanggang 32 yung clipping point. It means to say, hindi basta-basta magdi-distort. Mataas ang inyong headroom. Okay? Something like that. Okay? So that is your LED meter. Next, on the digital now, we heard this a dozen times or a lot of times in the sellers of the digital mixing console. This is a real-time analyzer or an RTA. This is a professional audio device that measures and displays the frequency spectrum of an audio signal. So this gives you an idea what are the frequencies na sobra at kulang. Ano yung kulang sa kanya at sobra sa kanya. Sana lahat nalalaman na natin kung anong kulang sa kanya para pupunuan natin siya ng ating pagmamahal. Ganun ba yun? Okay? So, kamuli ng pinto si Direk eh. Okay? So, ang nangyayari dito ngayon ay dito, this indicates what frequencies needs to be cut or to be tamed down during may feedback kayo sa inyong operations, sa inyong sound system. Naalala ko, nagturo ako ng XR18 kahapon, exclusively sa Proclaiming Jesus Ministries in Hagunoy. So, pinakikita namin doon sa training namin kung ano yung sobrang frequency, yun ang pwedeng bawasan, pinapakita yung naka-boost. Then we could work, bring it down, okay? Doctor lang po ba ito? Akala ko sound tech session. Okay? So, okay. So, ang nangyayari dito ay, yung mga, nakita nyo po on the right side, no? In that particular, yellow ones, shows us may naka-boost na frequency. So, we need to pinpoint that and bring it down. Okay? Pwede natin Hello from hi, I'm going to speak in English. It's because there's people from Kenya. There's a pastor from Kenya right now, okay? So, So this particular real-time analyzer, okay, gives us an idea of, yan, sorry ngayon na to all of you, mag-English ako tuloy. This is the reason why it is designed or created, because for you to have a reference of which frequencies you need to cut down or to boost. Okay? And some, I mean, this is a reference, a tool, but this will not replace our ear. Okay, guys? Just to point this out, that this real-time analyzer will not replace our ears to identify the frequencies that needed attention. Needed attention again, ah. Okay? Needed to focus on, to cut down, is because those are the offending frequencies that gives you feedback or howling sound during your performance. Alright? Then, the next one, this is a sample of real-time analyzer that you can find in audio analysis application. Okay, not to mention the brands because I'm not endorsing any brands here. So, this shows, okay, example, there's a feedback example at 1.6 kilohertz. 1.6 kilohertz. So, this tells you which particular frequencies you need to cut down using your graphic equalizer. So, ito nakakatulong. I hope that everyone nakakatulong. Okay? In short sa Tagalog, sana all nakakatulong. Hindi nakakasakit ng damdamin. Okay? Yung ba yun? Okay? So, again guys, to those people who would like to know more about digital audio mixing console using the RTA, spectrograph, etc., RTA, I would like to invite you to our upcoming, upcoming August Digital Audio Mixing Console Masterclass. We have a schedule on August entitled Digital Audio Mixing Console Masterclass. Okay, we're going to teach you how to calibrate and to ring out the feedback. Anyway, to continue. So the real-time analyzer or the RTA helps you, okay, shows you which particular frequencies you need to cut down during your calibration and for you to know where's the feedback coming from. There are some churches that the feedback, they're calling it as a bad spirit because they're trying to rebuke that. Ang tawag nila doon, masamang spirito. Pero hindi naman po masamang spirito ang feedback eh. Okay? Sabi nila, we rebuke the spirit of feedback in this church before we start our service. No. It is a technical problem. It's a calibration speaker. What is feedback? A feedback, okay, yan yung bumabalik. Lahat ng bumabalik, lahat ng bumabalik sa buhay mo, hindi minsan maganda. Okay, yung mga tapos na, bumabalik, pabalik-balik, masama talaga yan eh. Okay, feedback daw yan. Okay, masamang spirito daw, sabi nung, may na-comment ba dito? Parang masamang spirito, bumabalik. Okay, so a feedback is a loop. Okay, a loop, bumabalik. The microphone captures the speakers. The microphone captures the stage monitor. Okay, malakas ang stage monitor. The band is too loud in the stage. That's the reason why you have a feedback. Why? Your stage monitor is competing with your what? Okay? With your stage amplifiers and your band in the stage. Turuto na ito. Nakakasakit. Okay. So yun. Okay, hi to all of you guys. I hope you're still with me. Okay? Now, just to give you, ang dami kong pinupunta, I've been visiting different churches. Now, yung microphone natin, hindi dapat nagpi-feedback. Bakit hindi dapat nagpi-feedback? You should not be having some feedback. It's because your microphone should be, take note, farther away from the main speakers, and your microphone should be, I mean, your monitor speaker should be installed at the rear side of the microphone. In short, kaya nga nasa floor. That's the reason why your monitor speakers is at the floor side, which is the off-axis side of the microphone. Nasa baba. Okay? Yan. So, this is RTA. Next is spectrograph. Ito ha. Spectrum over time with amplitude. This measures the frequency and time. So, remember guys, sound has time. So, parang pag-ibig lang. Anong pagkakahalin tulad ng pag-ibig sa kanang sound? Parehas sila na kailangan ng time. Ayan, both of them needs time. Why? Our ear sometimes needs time for us to understand the sound that we hear. Do you agree with me, guys? Okay? Okay, I'm going to answer your questions, guys. You can comment your questions. I'm going to read all of your questions regarding what I discussed a while today. Okay? I still have 10 minutes of my time. Meron pa kayong 10 minutes, guys, for me to answer your questions. Okay? Sana all my time. Okay? Sound also times because it transfers, okay? It i-transmit and to the receiver. So ibig sabihin nun, there's time. There's also delay of time. Okay, same thing. I'm transmitting right now our audio and the video, but there's also delays because the Facebook and the internet will be able to transmit the data to you guys and to the server and for you to receive it. Okay? So meron tinatawag na time. Real-time adjustable dynamic range. So yung mga colors na yun, those are color representations of certain loudness per frequency. That's the reason why it shows to us there's an indicator from 20 Hz to 20,000. From 20 Hz to 20,000 Hz. Or from 20 Hz to 20 kHz. Okay? I did remember if you have some feedback, di ba? Masakit sa tenga, correct? Masakit sa tenga. And at ang feedback na yan, you need to tame down those frequencies. And yung feedback na yan, it hurts. Okay? It hurts. H-E-R-T-Z. It hurts. It's because it's a frequency. Okay? Again, guys, hurts. It hurts in the ear and it hurts in the pocket. It's because you might have a busted speaker system if there is a prolonged feedback during your performance or during your operations. Okay? It hurts. Not H-E-R-T-Z. Okay? It hurts. Sa mga gustong bumili ng t-shirt ko na it hurts, pwede na kayong bumili. Maglalabas, ibabalik ko ulit yung t-shirt namin, it hurts. It hurts, hindi lang sa tenga, kundi sa puso. Pwede ba yun? Okay? So again, these colors, yung kulay pula na yan, those are the point of concerns that we need to tame down. Sobrang ma-bass, sobrang ma-mid, ma-low mids. You need to bring down. Example, it's show to us that there is approximately 125 Hz. Okay? Boom on that particular frequency. So you need to tame down on the parametric equalizer. On the parametric equalizer. Okay? So this is called a spectrograph analyzer. And this, you can find this also in some of audio analysis application. Ano, on that particular screen. So that is called spectrograph. Magkaiba po yung tinatawag na real-time analyzer, RTA, this is different, and spectrograph analyzer, then the next one would be fast Fourier transform, FFT. Ito medyo mahal ito. Mas accurate ito, this is an important measurement method in the science of audio and acoustical measurement. This converts a signal into individual spectral components and thereby provides frequency information about the signal. So this measures the frequency response curve of the speaker system. This could be used for you to time align the speakers, the woofer, the mid-range, and the tweeter. Ginagamit namin to to calibrate, to align. Ang tawag nito, time alignment. Align the speaker system so they will arrive on time, hindi delay. Parang Lazada and Shopee, di ba? Sana, di ba sa Lazada and Shopee, alam natin kung kailan darating in order natin. Okay? Pero yung soulmate mo, alam mo bang kailan, kung kailan siya darating? Okay? Di ba minsan hindi eh. Kailan kaya siya darating? Hindi ko alam eh. Buti pa yung Lazada and Shopee, alam ko kung kailan darating sa buhay ko. Parang sound din yan. So dapat sabay yung dating, no? Dating sa buhay mo tuloy. Yan naman tayo. Okay? So, again, the speaker system should be aligned together. Alam niyo po ba na ang tunog ng stage monitor also heard by your audience, by your congregation in front? Okay? Meaning to say, kailangan naka-time align lahat ng speaker. To those people who would like to know more kung ano ang reference sa pagta-time align, join our master classes, guys, especially on the Analog Audio System Masterclass and Digital Audio Mixing Console Masterclass. Tina-time align po all of those speakers. So it will arrive on time at the same time to your audience or listeners. So again, this is Fast Fourier Transform FFT. This is an application. Kailangan gumamit kayo ng microphone. Meron kayong audio interface and it should be connected to your computer, okay, for you to test the frequency response and the sound produced by your speaker system. Okay, let me recap. What are the recommended tools for measurements on sound technology? Number one, punta tayo doon. Number one, multimeter. Dapat meron tayo niyan. Sound level meter. A sound technician who's going to be paid. A sound engineering design consultant should have all of this. Hindi po pwedeng mata-mata, tenga-tenga at pang may bumisita sa inyong church, dala-dala brochure. Hindi po siya sound engineer. Kapag pinopromote po sa kanyang Facebook page, puro products, puro brand, puro sale, puro mga 24 months to pay, hindi po yan consultant, yan po ay sales engineer. Hindi naman po masama. Okay? So, okay lang po yan, pero ang tawag sa kanila ay sales engineer o salesman. Next, sound level meter, distance meter, volume unit meter, nakikita ninyo, you can find that in your audio equipment, LED meter, real-time analyzer that you can find in your digital audio mixing console, spectrograph that you can find also in your real-time in your digital mixing console, and past Fourier transform for you to tune, calibrate your speaker system that includes the RTA, the spectrograph, and the FFT that you can use an application using your computer and microphone. Okay? Alright, we've seen our Tech Talk video. Again, to those who have questions regarding our topic in this video, kindly comment below. Before we end, please subscribe to our channel and share it to your friends. We would like to invite you to enroll on our upcoming online and hands-on master classes on live, studio, and broadcast that includes live streaming and recording for music production. Visit markyulo.com or contact +63 920 963 4103 to know more. See you on our next video.